Okay, very good afternoon class. Okay, today I'm going to continue with vector and scalar. So where I'm going to teach you, I'm going to explain about vector and then scalar. Okay, this is the chapter 5, the last chapter for this sem. So we are going to finish this chapter by 2 weeks and then we're going to start do revision. Okay, before I start this chapter, I'm going to explain to you chapter vector and scalar is considered very easy chapter and you can score. Seriously, you can score 25 marks. Okay, but without careless mistake, you need to do without careless mistake. So first, this chapter is from AdMaths. I think so some of you don't like this chapter. Why? Very easy or you can't understand the simple basic knowledge. Okay, most of you don't understand the knowledge. That's why you don't feel like to take these questions. Actually, it's very simple and you need to understand the concept. That's all. So now I'm going to explain to you and then we're going to target this question for final. Okay, vector. What is vector? Okay, I'm going to explain to you. I'm going to explain to you and then I'm going to teach some questions first with the basic. Okay, a vector is a quantity that has both a magnitude and direction. So if you see vector and scalar a bit different. Vector has magnitude and has its direction. Okay? It is represented by an arrow whereby the length of the arrow is the magnitude. So you have one arrow, so it's the value is magnitude, and then the arrow itself indicates the directions. So whether towards north, south, it's showing the arrow where is it. Okay, for example, this is the arrow. You can see it is towards downwards. Okay, doesn't mean where is it. So you should know it's from one point to another point. So we can state that is to example Ipoh to KL. So example A to B. So this vector is called AB, vector AB or vector A, or you can name it whatever vector with the symbol of arrow on top. So you can see right A. So this is vector A. Or I can name it this vector is vector AB. So there's one point is A, another point is I can call it as vector AB. For example, I can mention this vector. So this is my point A and this is B. So I did like this arrow. So my vector will be A towards B. So how I'm going to write this vector is A, B, and then it must show from A to B. First, you should understand this concept. So it means from A towards B. So how I'm going to write vector AB. Okay, so there's another vector like this. So this is P, this is Q. But my direction is towards P. So all I'm going to write is Q, P. So this is from Q to P. So from this symbol, you can understand what this vector means. Okay or not? Okay, next. The symbol for a vector is a letter with an arrow over it. Okay, so it means you can put any alphabets. Okay, it's according to your questions. Okay, next, scalar. What is scalar? Scalar are quantities which have magnitude without direction. So it means if there is a direction, it is called vector. If there's no direction, this is called scalar. Okay. Example of scalars, where we use the scalars is temperature, mass, kg, kinetic energy, time, and then density. So this is examples for the scalars. Okay, next. There's two ways to specify a vector. Okay, how are we going to specify a vector? Vector, it is either given by the question, a magnitude A and a direction of theta. Okay, for example, this is the drawing. So this is the drawing where if you draw in the graph paper, you'll be getting with the x-axis, y-axis, where you're going to mention the matrix, sorry, the vector is A vector, and then the angle is given is theta in this case. Okay, another way is from the proxy x and y also, but it is given in the x and y components where you called as ax and then ay. So you're going to find the value. So from this diagram you can see, okay, so this is the vector. So how you're going to find the value of x is you take the value for proxy x and then you take the value for proxy y, where you'll be getting the value for y. Okay, negative vectors. Okay, what is negative vector? It's a vector that has same magnitude but opposite direction. Okay, for example, this is my question, original. Okay, so I call this vector is vector AB. Okay, the magnitude for this vector, I can give you like example A. Okay, this is the magnitude class. Okay, how are we going to write the magnitude? Either you put the value A and then there's a wave on top, or you can write the wave down. Wave, eh? So you can make sure you selaraskan this. Either you put up or either you put down. But I'm going to practice put up only. So if I take this value, okay, this is my original vector. So I'm going to write, if the direction I'm changing, so this is vector AB with the magnitude is negative A. So I'm just changing the direction. This is the vector A. I mean the magnitude is value A. If I'm changing the direction, this side, so it'll be negative A. Can or not? Okay. Okay, vector negative A is a negative vector for A, but their magnitude still the same. The value of A is still same. Just the direction only you are changing. Okay. So, for example, you can see this. Here is a picture. A, and then when I change the direction, it will be negative A. Okay, magnitude vector. So if magnitude, there's two types of magnitude you're going to find for 2D and 3D. Okay, two dimensional. Okay, for example, OP, or we call is vector A. Okay, what is the formula is, okay, vector. You can write, for example, OP, vector OP, you can write in forms of matrix X and Y. Or you can write in form of x, I, plus y, j. So it means you can write in this matrix form or you can write in this form. Either one. So when you get either one form, you need to convert. Okay, what is the formula for this one? Okay, this is vector OP. So what is the magnitude? OP. Okay, this thunder modulus is called magnitude. Okay, so it's equivalent to square root x power of 2 plus y power of 2. So it means x power of 2 means you just take the value of x, and then this is y power of 2, you just take the value of y power of 2. So it means from, if in this way you take the value in front only. Okay, I'm going to show you next the example. If 3D, three dimensional, okay, you can see this is the formula. Square root of x power of 2 plus y power of 2. If 3D. 3D means you'll be getting x, y, z. Okay. So, what is the formula? You just add on x power of 2 plus y power of 2 plus z power of 2. Can see or not?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Very easy, eh? Daripada senyuman you all. Nampak. Okay. Unit vector. You listen first, then only we do the questions. Okay, what is unit vector? Unit vector is dimensions vector with a magnitude of exactly 1. So whatever we learn magnitude, we're going to apply here. So unit vectors are used to specify a direction of no other physical significance. So what is the formula for unit vector is, okay, what is the thunder? You can see enough. Unit vector we call like this. U, okay, example at U. Okay, the thunder is like this. Unit vector equals to vector U over magnitude of vector U. So it means this is the unit vector. If there's a symbol like this, you should know this is unit vector. Okay, you write the vector and then you need to over then magnitude. Okay, so if there's a question, okay, example. Okay, find magnitude and unit vector for U equals to 4i minus 7k. Okay, class, how to find magnitude for this question? Just now I told you, right? This is the magnitude. So, U equals to, in this case, is 4i minus 7k. Okay, so remember, modulus U. Modulus is U is equivalent to magnitude. So equivalent to square root 4 power of 2 plus negative 7 power of 2. So use your calculator, you will be getting this answer. So the solution is, you can see here. Okay, already done here. Okay, you see, actually, supposed to be 3D is I, J, K. But in this question, only I and K left. Okay, you can see in my PowerPoint there. Okay, here I write 4 power of 2 plus negative 7 power of 2. Okay, actually, there's a 0. Okay, you didn't put also, no problem. So, I just write like this. Okay, actual, there's 4 power of 2 plus 0 power of 2 plus negative 7 power of 2. And then the answer will be, you'll be getting square root of 65. Okay, class. Square root of 65, you can use a calculator and you get the value. So, it's 8.062. Okay? But when you write the unit vector, make sure you write in this form. Okay, continue. So, this question is unit vector. Okay. You cannot write 4i minus 7k over 8.062. Cannot. You must write square root of 65. Okay. Then you must separate the equation like this. 4 over square root of 65i minus 7 over square root of 65k. Can understand or not? Okay. Or if you want to use the decimal, change directly like this. 0.496i minus 0.868k. So, this one you need to use calculator. I think so directly you no need to use calculator. Just leave the answer the above. Can or not? Okay. So, if we continue. Operation of vectors. Okay, addition. So, you're going to plus and then there is no minus subtraction in vector. Okay, so there's addition only vector. So it means there's no subtraction. Okay, where it happens, subtraction is negative vector only. So understand, and there's no minus vector. It will be negative vector only. So for example, if you see, vector addition sometimes called triangle law. Okay, where you're going to use? Okay, so you can see two types of vector. Vector U and then vector V. Okay, when we do addition, so it will be, this is vector U plus V. Okay, resultant vector. So I'm going to teach you resultant vector. Okay, the first question is AB plus BC plus CD.